Hey everyone, welcome back to today's lesson. So guys, how are you all? I hope you all are doing well. So as you can see behind me, what's written on the board, when not to use the. Now the is a definite article, as you all know, because I am hoping that you guys have watched the video on definite article the, how to use it, what are the rules for using definite article the. So I thought, why not make another video where I can tell you where not to use definite article the, because I have seen students getting really confused that, ma'am, do I use it here, do I use it there, or whatever is that. So that made me do this video. So that's why I'm here with this video. So guys, without wasting any further time, we'll start our today's lesson. My name is Sanya and I welcome you all in today's lesson with a big heart. Okay, so we'll start with our lesson now. So the first thing that I have written on the board is, we don't use definite article the with names of countries. Now you must be wondering that in the previous video, like, I have taught you that we can use definite articles, we can use definite article the with the names of the country. But guys, remember carefully what I taught you. I taught you that yes, we can use definite article the with names of the country, but with those countries which have plural names. Plural names of countries. Just like I have given you the examples of Philippines and Netherlands. And I told you one more rule where to use definite article the with countries. The countries in whose name there are words like United, Kingdom, or Republic. Okay? So these are the exceptions for this rule. We don't use definite article the with names of country, but if the country name is plural, or if in the name of the country there are words like United Kingdom or Republic, then we will use the. Otherwise, we will not use the with the names of the remaining or any other country. So the example is, Germany is an important economic power. So I have not put the here because there is no United Kingdom or Republic in its name, and similarly it is not a plural name of a country as well. So Germany is an important economic power. Similarly, I can say, I would like to visit, I would like to visit Australia. Okay guys, so maine kaha hai, I'm so sorry, that's just a slip of tongue. Okay, so I would like to visit Australia. So over here as well, I have not used definite article the, because Australia, it's neither a plural name for a country, neither there is any United Kingdom or Republic. So these are the two exceptions for using definite article the with the names of countries. So remember that. Okay, so we'll move on. Okay, next is, we do not use definite article the with names of languages. Okay, just like, I am fluent in speaking English. So which language I can speak fluently? English. Okay, well understood. But I have not put the here. Why? Because I'm talking about a language. And when we talk about a language, we don't use definite article the. Okay, so one more example that I can give you is, French is widely spoken in Canada. Okay, so it is a fact that, you know, many people who live in Canada, they speak French, though English is also spoken there as well, but majority of people also speak French. So not the French, only French. Okay, so the next rule for not using the definite article the is, we don't use it with the names of meals. So now I hope you all must be knowing the meals. We have three meals in one day, which are breakfast, lunch, and dinner. So when we are talking about these meals, guys, we don't use definite article the. So the example is, lunch is my favorite meal. Okay, which is true. Like I love eating lunch. I enjoy eating lunch. Okay, so I have not written, or I will not say, the lunch is my favorite meal. Okay, similarly, one more example that I can give you here is, I like to eat breakfast early morning. Okay, so I like to eat breakfast early morning. Here, early morning, guys, doesn't mean at 5 o'clock or at 6 o'clock for sure. Okay, there is late morning as well, which is from like 10 o'clock to 12 noon. Okay, so like I don't like having my breakfast during late morning. I like to have my breakfast in the early morning. So over here as well, I haven't used anything. I have not used the definite article the over here as well. Okay, so we don't use definite article the with the names of meals as well. Next we have is, we do not use with profession. So guys, if you remember, so I have told you that what do we use with the names of professions. I have taught you that we use either indefinite article an or either indefinite article a with the names of professions or jobs. So that goes here as well. I have written, I want to be an engineer and not the engineer. Okay guys, so next up is uncountable nouns. So you people know what uncountable nouns are. Uncountable nouns are those nouns which you cannot count. Okay, all the abstract ideas, all the liquids, all the gases, and all those things which are made up of smaller parts. Okay, all those are uncountable nouns. Okay, so we also don't use definite article the with uncountable nouns. Just like I have written, sugar is sweet, and I have not written the sugar is sweet, because sugar is an uncountable noun because it is made up of small grains. Okay, similarly, I will say, rice is a staple diet in North India. So over here as well, I am saying rice, and I'm not saying the rice, because rice again is uncountable noun. So rice is a staple diet. Staple diet is like, you know, what people usually eat or they like to eat, or it is a main part of their food that they eat. Okay, so rice is a staple diet in North India. So the people who live in North India, they like eating rice. But guys, there is one exception to this rule as well. When we specify uncountable noun, then we can use the. So for example, if I say that the rice that I ate at lunch in your house were delicious. Okay, so I'm specifying that which rice, the rice that I ate at the lunch in lunch at your house, you know, the rice which was eaten by me at your place were very delicious. So here I am specifying this uncountable noun. So when we specify uncountable noun, then we can use the. Okay, next up we have is, we do not use definite article the with ears. Okay, so this is a very common mistake that students do in their speaking as well as in their writing as well, and I have come across many students like that. Okay, they write, he was born in the year 1995. No, it is wrong. Grammatically it is incorrect, because we don't use definite article the before years. It will be like, he was born in 1995. This is the correct statement. Okay, you don't have to add the. Even there is no need to add a or an as well. So neither a an nor the. Okay, next is with names of shops. Now guys, we don't even use definite article the with the names of shops, though I am actually telling the exact name of the shop, that what the name of the shop is, but still then I am not going to use definite article the over there. So It is that I left my card at Smith's. Okay, so like I'm trying to say that I left my card, maybe my debit card or maybe my credit card or my credit card. I forgot that card at Smith's. So it is a name of a shop. Okay, where I have left my card. So I have not said at the Smith's, at Smith's. Neither will use a or an here as well. Similarly, I can say, can you go to Boots for me? I want to buy certain, can you go with me? Or I can say, can you come with me to Boots? I'm going for shopping. Okay, so I have said, can you come with me to Boots? Now Boots is a particular shop where I am going, and then I also asked my friend that, would you like to join me? Would you like to come with me? I'm going there to buy for shopping. Okay, so we'll also not use the with the names of shops as well. Next we have is, this I already told you, we don't use the with the names of individual mountains, just like I have given you the example of Mount Everest, if you people remember, and with the individual islands. Okay, so if I'm saying, if I'm asking someone, have you visited Long Island? So guys, I'm specifying, like, this is the name of the island, Long Island. I'm asking someone, like, have you been to that particular island? Now see, here as well, I am specifying, but I'm not using the here, okay? Because we will not use the with one island, okay, with individual name of island. Rather, we use it for a group of island or for a group of mountain ranges. Just like I can say that Mount McKinley is the highest mountain in Alaska. Whereas I will not say the Mount McKinley, because Mount McKinley is definitely in a particular mountain range. Okay, so if I talk about that mountain range, then I can use the. But if I am talking about one particular mountain of that mountain range, then I will not use the with the name of that mountain. And the last rule, or the last place where we don't actually use definite article the, is with the names of villages, towns, cities, parks, streets as well. This is also a common mistake which students do. Forest and stations as well. Okay, so we don't use definite article the with the names of these places. So I will say that Sahil lives in Sydney. Okay, so guys, what is Sydney here? Sydney is a name of a city. It's a city in Australia. Okay, so I will not use definite article over here, or I will not say Sydney lives in the Australia. No, that will be grammatically incorrect. Okay, so don't use it before the names of cities. Similarly, if I use it, I'll not even use it with the names of streets. So like, can you direct me to Woodhill Street? Okay, so it is a name of a street, Woodhill Street. Now I am going to my friend's home. So Woodhill Street is a name of a street. So guys, say for example, like, you know, there is a friend of mine and she has shifted to her new house, and I don't know where her house is actually. She just told me that it's at the Woodhill Street. Okay, so like, I don't know how to reach there. So what I did, there was a stranger. Okay, so I asked that person that, can you direct me to the Woodhill Street? Can you tell me the way where the Woodhill Street actually is, or can you tell me the directions? Okay, so over here as well, I will not say, can you direct me to the Woodhill Street? No, that will be grammatically wrong, because we don't use definite article the before the names of streets as well. I will say, can you direct me to Woodhill Street? Okay, so guys, these are the few places, okay, or these are the few rules I say, like, which tells us when not to use definite article the. And I hope now all your confusions and doubts are clear, where to use articles and where not to use definite article the. So if you found this video helpful, like the video, and guys, I'll see you in the next lesson with an interesting topic probably. Till then, take care and stay tuned.